Good morning, everybody, and welcome to News Views. I'm Judy Hsu. This past week has been one for brain power here in Chicago. Richard Thaler, an economics professor at the University of Chicago, was awarded the Nobel Prize for Economic Science. Now, Thaler is considered one of the founding fathers of behavioral economics. He studies how we think about money and rationalize how we spend it. The Nobel comes with a $1 million prize. That announcement was followed by the MacArthur Foundation naming 24 people as Genius Grant recipients, and two of them are from right here in Chicago, including Dawu Bey, who is a photographer and he teaches at Columbia College. His work captures people from marginalized communities. And then we have Rami Nashashibi. He also joins the exclusive MacArthur Club. He is the executive director of the Inner City Muslim Action Network and works to build bridges across racial, religious, and socioeconomic divides. And we are incredibly happy to have Rami join us here as our guest for this morning's News Views. Nice to have you here.
Thank you so much, Judy. Yeah, good morning.
Well, first of all, congratulations.
Thank you.
Got to ask you, how did you find out? We had a chance to chat a little bit. You found out a little bit before everybody else did.
Yeah, well, that's how it typically goes. There's typically the call. In my case, it was the call in. In other words, I was actually brought in under the pretense of a meeting that they wanted to have with me. And entered into a room with seven people sitting there, including the president and CEO of MacArthur, Julia Stash. And at that point, I was convinced something seriously wrong had happened, or they were going to give me some news about some issue. And that's when they informed me that I had been awarded the fellow. And I kind of had that out-of-body, very surreal experience at that moment in front of seven women, in fact, at the MacArthur Foundation.
No kidding. And you had to keep it a secret for a little bit.
So, yeah, you're sworn to secrecy. You can tell one other person. In my case, that was my wife.
Now, this award, just so everybody knows, you don't apply for it.
No.
You knew, did you have an idea that you were up for it?
Because absolutely
you're
not.
Sort of nominated by another group, right?
Yeah, no, I had absolutely no idea. And most of the fellows don't. It's a very kind of secretive process. And I think their nominations, I still quite don't know how it works, but been told it's a very rigorous vetting, lots of intense conversations. And when the announcement is given to you, it is typically a big surprise, as it was for me.
Well, it is, of course, for your years of work, and let's talk a little bit about that with the Inner City Muslim Action Network. Tell us about the mission of that group.
Well, you know, at the core of our mission is this idea of aspiring to be a source of health, wellness, and healing in the inner city. Iman, as it's known, does that through a holistic health clinic that we run that provides everything from behavior health to primary care services through a program called Green Reentry that works with returning citizens, the formerly incarcerated, as well as the 18 to 25 youth demographic that is in danger of kind of being criminalized or has already been in touch with the system. We take vacant, vandalized homes in that program in a concentrated number of really troubled blocks and use those sites as a job training and preparation program and then a housing program for that same population.
Did you get a whole lot of support for that? Was that difficult to, you know, kind of launch something like that?
You know, it took a long time. It's kind of, we're now in our seventh cohort. This is the largest cohort we've had of around 36 intergenerational guys who mix of guys who come home from prison recently, as well as young 18 to 25 year olds. And you know, it's grown, and it did take a while to demonstrate this as a kind of a proof of concept that it actually can work. But what's been extraordinary is seeing how just taking two or three properties in some of the most troubled blocks and then providing that block with intense levels of engagement through this cohort can fundamentally change the quality of life. And that's happened. And so as people have kind of gradually seen this as a model that works, the support for it has also increased over the years.
All right, we're going to just take a quick break right here. We're going to come back and talk a whole lot more about the other programs in the neighborhoods and also a little bit more about his background and how he came to Chicago and all of that. Again, our recipient, one of our recipients of the Genius Award from the MacArthur Foundation. We'll be right back.